So you've got people attending church online. That's great. But how do you get them to truly engage with what you're doing week after week or even minute by minute? Let's talk about how to lead your people to become more engaged in your content. My name is Amanda Sims, and I am one of the host team pastors for Life.Church Online. What that means is that I get to lead volunteers who are serving in our online services all throughout the week on multiple different platforms. I'm excited to talk to you today about how we lead people and how you can lead people to become more engaged in your online content. Engagement is really important because really you're leading your people to take next steps. And that's what spiritual life is all about. Everyone has a best next step, and engagement helps you help them take those steps. You want to treat your audience like the primary audience. They're just as important as the people in your buildings, and so make sure that you're talking to them. Talk to them from camera. Acknowledge them in your services. Call them out and lead them to participate. In fact, you can even ask them to engage in the chat. Ask them where they're from. Tell them to type it in the chat. Ask them to type amen in the chat. Lead them to take that step of engaging with your community. Here at Life.Church, one of the platforms we use is the Church Online platform. And I love this platform because it gives us lots of tools we can use to lead our attendees to become more engaged. In fact, I love the Moments tool because these are great prompts to lead our attendees to engage with us in easy ways. Like there's an invite moment where if someone clicks it, they can send an invite to somebody on social media to bring more people to Church Online. And who doesn't want that? There's a moment where you can request prayer and lead your team to ask for prayer in those one-on-one personal conversations. And honestly, those conversations are powerful. So many people engage deeply in what's happening with Church Online when they can open up in vulnerability and share their prayer request and receive prayer one-on-one. That's a powerful way that you can have your team engage with your people. As I mentioned, I get to lead volunteers who are serving in our live services, and these volunteers are trained to engage with our attendees and lead them to take great next steps. We actually empower our volunteers with lots of prompts, chat prompts that they can use in those services, including links to maybe, how do I start a small group, or I'd like to sign up for the newsletter. And here's a fun fact. When you use that connect moment, you can use that to get someone's email address. When you get their email address, you can communicate with them, not just in that one service, but all throughout the week. You know, there's 168 hours in a week, and that service is just 1 hour of their life. But if you can connect with them in that moment and then connect with them outside the service, that's a big win for your ministry. There's a ton of next steps you could lead people to, and you'll do that individually, one by one, with their best next step personally. But there's also a lot of power when the whole team comes around one big push. In fact, right now, our team is pushing on the invite moment because we know that that's powerful. We're in a popular series. We want more people to come. So the entire team is rallying around, how do we make that invite moment powerful? So when you, as a team, decide, here's the one thing we're going to push this week or this series and really lean in, you'll see a lot of momentum there. So we've covered a lot of ground. Let's go through it again real quick. Bullet points. Ready? So first, make sure that you're communicating to your audience as a primary audience. They're part of your community. Make sure you talk to them that way. Actually ask your people to engage. People actually like to follow directions. So when you lead them, they're probably more likely to take that step and engage in your content. If you use the Church Online platform, use Moments. They are great tools to invite people to ask for prayer or to invite others to come to Church Online. Equip your hosts to lead your attendees to their next steps in that chat. Find ways to connect with your attendees outside that 1 hour service that they can stay connected with you all throughout the week. And pick one thing to zero in on to lead your attendees to take that specific next step. And speaking of engagement, you know, you could help our engagement right now. You could like this video, you could comment on it, and you could subscribe for even more great content.